Now, to understand string theory, we need to understand how string theory was brought about. And to start our string theory story, it all starts with gravity. Now, I know you may have heard about the so-called Isaac Newton finding the apple fall from the tree, blah, blah, blah. But here is the real story.
Ugh, I'm so distressed. I can't find out what is holding us to the ground. I don't know what to do. And, an apple? This isn't even an apple tree. I think I just discovered gravity.
Okay, so it didn't really happen that way. We lied.
Einstein speculated that there is a space-time fabric, and that fabric acts like a trampoline. If you place a heavy object in the middle, it'll bend and warp with the mass. If you place another object on that, it'll move with the force of gravity.
Like a circle. Not like a triangle. Triangle has ends. Like a circle.
You know what? I gotta be truthful with you. I'm not a scientist. I just like the chair.
So, if gravity is so strong, then why isn't it when we jump up and down, we don't fall straight to the center of the Earth? Well, this is because of electromagnetism! Now, my friend Aisha...
What up, Aisha?
...is going to demonstrate electromagnetism versus gravity. Now, as you can see, she didn't fall straight to the center of the Earth. This is because the electrons in her body and the electrons in the ground repel with such a force that it makes it completely impossible for her to travel to the center of the Earth, making electromagnetism, the force between her electrons and the ground, millions of times greater than gravity.
Now, I'm the founder of string theory, and I don't know how to put this, but around here, I'm kind of a big deal.
Got it! N equals 496.
Oh, okay, I got it.
What does all this mean?
I have a loose thread.
Strings!
People who believe in string theory are labeled as crackpots, or people who've gone bananas.
In quantum mechanics, everything is unpredictable. And everything is also possible. So, with quantum mechanics, I could actually walk right through this wall. Of course, that would take an eternity to do, but eventually I should be able to just step right through.
It's dark! Help me!
It was Einstein's dream to have unifications. This is where general relativity and quantum mechanics were put together in one law. Well, this is kind of complicated because quantum mechanics and general relativity are like two feuding families in the same house. On one side, you have general relativity, the calm, predictable side, like this. this. Now, without string theory, our house would probably look a little something like this.
Guys, hey! We are trying to study here.
Yeah, you're messing with our groove.
Oh my god!
Ow!
But with string theory, our house calms down and comes together. Like this.
Nice day.
Very.
Yes. Good tea.
Who made this?
I brewed it myself.
Oh my goodness! I can't find out why we don't... I forgot what I was supposed to say! Oh, I am so distressed! I can't find out what is holding us to the earth! I don't know what to do! Oh! Goodness, I'm so distressed. I can't find out what's keeping us to the earth. Oh, I don't know what to do.
Action.
Okay, so that's not really... Oh my god! So, if gravity is so strong, then why is it that when we jump up and down, we don't fall right to the center of the earth? Well, this is because of electromagnetism! She's going to demonstrate electromagnetism versus gravity. It was Einstein's dream to have unification. This is where gravity and electromagnetism was combined with the three... What are you doing?
Oh, my God.
Go, babe!